ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா 13th சாப்டர் க்ஷேத்ர க்ஷேத்ரஜ்ஞ விபாக யோகம். பகவான் கிருஷ்ணா இஸ் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் தி டிஃபரன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் க்ஷேத்ரம் தட் இஸ் ஃபீல்ட் பாடி அண்ட் க்ஷேத்ரஜ்ஞ தி ஆத்மா ஹூ இஸ் தி நோயர் ஆஃப் தி ஃபீல்ட். இன் திஸ் சாப்டர் இனிஷியலி ஹி ஸ்டார்டட் highlighting the difference between the two, saying that these two entities exist, and then he explained about kshetram, the body or the matter, primordial matter and other aspects of the matter, and subsequently he started explaining kshetrajna, jivatma. But before explaining jivatma, he explained the 20 qualities which are expected in a jivatma who is desirous of self-realization and realizing Bhagavan, starting with Amanitvam, Adhambitvam in the shlokams 7 to 11. In those 5 shlokams, he identified 20 important qualities and he said that those 20 qualities are the real aspects to know, and anything outside those qualities are to be discarded. We need not pursue any of those other aspects. Only those 20 qualities need to be pursued. Saying that, Bhagavan concluded the 20 qualities which are required. Those 20 qualities are very, very important for jivatmas to realize Bhagavan and to realize the self as well. We can see that all our acharyas, they were all filled with these 20 qualities, starting from Sriman Athamunigal, Bhagavad Ramanuja, Embar, Bhattar, Nanjiyar, Nambillai, Manavala Mamunigal, all of those acharyas and the other acharyas who are not listed here. All of those Purva acharyas were filled with these qualities. They were embodiment of these qualities and they were prime examples of one, how one should conduct oneself in pursuit of Bhagavan and Shastram. So after explaining these qualities, Bhagavan proceeds to explain about the Jivatma further, the Kshetrajna, in the next set of shlokams. Bhagavad Ramanuja has given beautiful commentary for Shri Bhagavad Gita, named Gita Bhashyam. Vedantacharya has given Tatparya Chandrika, which is another Sanskritam commentary for Bhagavad Gita. With the help of these two, Puttur Sri Uve Krishna Swami Iyengar has given elaborate Tamil commentary for Bhagavad Gita. As part of that, he has also given word by word meanings, and we have translated that into English. With the help of this English translation, we are going through simple meanings for these shlokams. Let us start with the 12th shlokam. Now we have to see that when Bhagavan is talking about Atma Swarupam, he is talking about Muktatma Swarupam, the true nature of the Atma in its real state. When Atma is in this samsara, since time immemorial, there is no beginning. Atmas have been in this samsara, covered with ignorance, covered with matter. But that is not the natural state of the Atma. Atma's state is pure knowledge and bliss. And that can be seen in the liberated state, Mukta state. So, Bhagavan is talking about this liberated state of Atma Swarupam here, because we can see from the usage of certain terms and certain explanations here that he is not talking about the bound soul, but he is talking about the soul Atma who is liberated. So let us see the shlokams now. 12th shlokam. Nyayam yat tat pravakshyami yat nyatvamrutam ashnute anadimat param ब्रह्म न सत्तन नासदुच्यते लेट अस सी द वर्ड बाय वर्ड मीनिंग्स यत् ज्ञात्वा नोइंग विच अमृतम अश्नुते अटेनिंग द इंपेरिशेबल स्टेट ऑफ आत्मा यत् तत् ज्ञेयम् अबाउट सच आत्मा विच इज टू बी नोन सो जनरली आत्मा इज एक्सप्लेन्ड एज द नोयर बट हियर बिकॉज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द मुक्तात्म स्वरूपम the nature of the true nature of the liberated atma the goal is to know about that particular state so here atma itself atma himself is shown as the prapyam or the goal who is to be understood who is to be known and understood pravakshyami I will explain you well bhagavan is saying I am going to explain to you about this principle clearly anadi beginningless so this atma is beginningless just like bhagavan has no beginning atma also has no beginning atma has been there forever and hence endless too one who is not created cannot be destroyed as well so bhagavan and atma are both eternal so here that beginningless quality is identified matparam my subordinate servitor bhagavan is saying that atma is subordinate to bhagavan it is not an atma is not an independent entity he is subordinate to bhagavan brahma he is great brahma means that which is huge or great because atma in the liberated state has fully expanded knowledge he is considered as brahma the word brahma is used for atma at times so this is one place where he is Bhagavan himself is saying atma is brahma that means he is having fully expanded knowledge tat that na sat na asat uchyate it is not known by the word sat atma in the effect state or asat atma in causal state this need to be understood clearly sat asat generally sat and asat are related to chit and achit that is sentient and insentient but here atma in the effect state is known as sat atma in the causal state is known as asat even bhagavan brahmam is said as asadva asatva idamagra asid that is brahmam is in the state of asat now that is during creation only primordial matter exists in the lila vibhuti at that time in the material realm only moola prakriti primordial matter is there and there is no distinguishing factor between atmas between matter there is we cannot differentiate anything everything will look there will be no form there will be no name in that state because there is no such action no form no state no qualities at that state even the brahmam bhagavan himself in the lila bhuti in the material realm he is known as asat so in the beginning only asat was there that's what shastram says and then happens creation at that time this moola prakriti and the atmas in the subtle form they transform into gross forms and then there is differentiation there is brahma there is rudra there is devatas there is humans there is birds animals different kinds of matter so all of that is visible so in that state atma is in the effect state known as sat existing but in the causal state atma is known as asat so this muktatma swarupam cannot be either compared to the sat cannot be identified by the word sat or asat because it is neither that muktatma is totally different the liberated soul is different from atma in the causal state or in the effectual state that is why krishna is saying that na sat na asat uchyate atma cannot be said as sat or asat here the muktatma cannot be said like that so bhagavan is saying in this shlokam I will explain to you clearly about the Atma, which is to be known, knowing which one attains the imperishable state. So, after having clear knowledge about Atma, one attains this state of liberation. So, that is explained in this shlokam, where Bhagavan says that Atma is anadi, beginningless. He is his own, Bhagavan's subordinate, servitor. Atma is great and is not known either by the word Sat or Asat. So that is 12th shlokam. 13th shlokam. Sarvatah panipadam tat sarvatokshi shiromukham sarvatah shruti malloke sarvam avritya tishtati. So in this shlokam, again, Bhagavan continues to explain about Atma. Tat, that pure Atma, sarvataha pani padam, can perform all activities of hands and feet. So whatever activities which are done by Atma with the body in this material realm, in the liberated state, that Atma can do all of that without the limbs. He can do with his sankalpam, his vow. Just by thought, he can accomplish all of that. Sarvatokshi shiro mukham, can perform all activities of eyes, head and face. Similar, whatever activities which are done using eyes, head and face, all of that can be done just with the sankalpam, with the thought in the Atma, in the liberated state. Sarvataha shruti mathe, can perform all activities of ears. Everywhere, similar concept, loke, in the world, sarvam, all entities, avritya, tishtati, pervading. This Atma, here Atma is indicated as one among all of the innumerable Atmas. So Atmas are pervading everywhere, they are present in every place in this world. That is one explanation. And Atma can also, in the liberated state, can pervade with the help of his knowledge, where his knowledge is fully expanded, he can pervade in many places. So, Atma is said to be pervading all entities in this world, in this context here. Now, 14th shlokam. Sarvendriya gunabhasam, sarvendriya vivarjitam, asaktam sarva britchaiva nirgunam, gunabhoktricha. Again, continuing on about the Muktatma Swarupam. Sarvendriya Gunabhasam, it is capable of knowing all actions with the sense organs. Naturally, with the sense organs, Atmas grasp knowledge and know about things. That is natural here in this material world itself. Sarvendriya Vivarjitam, but in its natural state, that is Atma in the liberated state, it is capable of knowing everything even without the sense organs. Again, with the sankalpa, with the vow, Atma can know everything. The limbs, the physical limbs and physical senses are not required. Here, in this material world, we have body and we have senses. Atma understands everything through the senses. But in the liberated state, Atma does not need the sense organs to understand everything, to know everything. Asaktam, naturally not connected to different types of bodies such as deva, celestial, manushya, human, tiryak, animal and stavara, plant. So here, the Atma in its true nature, in a liberated state, it is not connected to any of the materialistic bodies which we see in this material realm. Deva, manushya, tiryak, stavara are the four main types of species. So all of these bodies, they are not, Atmas are not directly connected in the liberated state to the materialistic species of bodies. Sarvabhrut cha eva, capable of assuming all types of bodies. Just as Atma is able to assume any different type of body in this material world, in the liberated state as well, Atma will have the capability to assume any form, any type of body. So that is sarvabhrut cha eva. Even in this bound state, if one can pursue many different bodies, what to speak of the liberated state, obviously one can assume all types of bodies. Nirgunam, naturally without the qualities such as sattva, rajas and tamas. So sattva, raja, tamo, gunas, these three qualities are part of this material realm. In the spiritual realm, in the Sri Vaikuntham, there is only Shuddha Sattvam, pure goodness. But here it's Mishra Sattvam, which is mixed with Rajogunam and Tamogunam. So Atma is said to be free from these three mixed qualities in the liberated state. In the liberated state, it will not have these three qualities which are part of the material realm. Atma will only have Sattvagunam, Shuddha Sattvagunam. Nirguna generally means free from or not present, qualities not present. But here Bhagavan is granting all the qualities to Atma while liberating the Atma. Hence naturally all the Shuddha Sattva qualities will be there in the Atma, but not Mishra Sattva qualities. And finally, Guna Bhoktrucha, capable of enjoying such qualities. So Atma will be capable of enjoying all such qualities. That is 14th shlokam. 15th shlokam. Bahirantascha Bhutanam Acharam Charam Yevacha Sukshmatvat Tat Avigneyam Durastam Chantikecha Tat. Here further the qualities are explained, the aspects are explained for the true nature of the Atma. Bhutanam Bahihi Antaha Cha. Atma is present both inside and outside the great elements, starting with Bhumi. So the five great elements are there: earth, water, air, ether and fire. So all the bodies which we see in this world, they are all made of these five elements. So Atma is present in the five elements when it is in the created state, that is in the sthula state. Atma can have bodies, and when Atma has bodies, Atma is present inside those bodies. But in the Moola Prakriti state, before creation, Atma is outside the five elements, and the liberated Atma is obviously outside the five elements of this material realm. So it is both outside the five great elements and it is inside the five great elements. Acharam charam evacha. It's naturally unmoving yet moving due to being connected with the body. When it is connected with the body, the Atma moves as the body moves. When it is outside the body, when it is not connected to a body, Atma stays where he is. It is, he is acharam, he is not movable at that stage. Sukshmatvat, due to being very subtle, tat, that Atma, avigneyam, is not known as something different from the body, though it resides in the same body. So Atma is present in a body, yet people don't realize the presence of the self in the body. They only see the body. The reason for that is Atma is very very subtle. Atma's size is very very tiny that we cannot even see the Atma through the eyes. So hence the Atma, even though inside the body, it is not known by the self because of the subtleness of the self. Tat, that Atma, durastam cha, though present inside one's own body, it stands very far for those who lack the qualities such as amanitvam, etc., and who have qualities contradictory to these. So for those who lack the good qualities and who have bad qualities, even though self is present right inside the body, one cannot realize oneself. The knowledge about the self is so far away from such person. Tat, that Atma, antikecha, it stands very near for those who have qualities such as amanitvam, etc. But when the same person is realized, he is having good qualities, as listed in Amanitvam, Adambitvam, those five shlokams. Then for that Atma, the self-realization, the knowledge about the self is very, very close. So in this manner, Atma is being explained by Bhagavan in these shlokams. We will continue on with this session in the next occasion. Alvar Emperumanar Jiyar Thiruvadigalai Sharanam, Jiyar Thiruvadigalai Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.